Alright everyone, Demoman here to talk about hoplites and phalanx formation and show you what a shield wall would sort of look like. I've got Mr. Green here to help me. He's using the shield, and this is a center grip shield. It doesn't have a boss, if you couldn't tell, but I positioned it so it would be like my Argive shield if he was holding it. The reason is, I'm going to talk about hoplites in this regard, particularly overarm versus underarm, which one in formation. Now, as you can see from just standing on my own, with the shield, it makes it easy to stab the stab. Whereas something like this, I'd have to come over. That also follows through in shield wall. Now, you'll have some people say, oh, well, you need to be holding the spear like this to go over. I'm going to tell you that that's complete bullshit, and I'm going to show you. Now, you'll notice something very convenient about this shield grip. Your right arm, where your spear is, nestles just perfectly at the lowest point in the shields. It's almost as if they intended for this to happen. I can, if it was more over here, still have my arm up more and do all the business. But over here, I don't have to. It's great fun. And if my arm gets tired, I can rest it here for a bit and then start fighting again. I'll rest it here and still kind of parry with it and off the side. You know, fight. It's the darndest thing, you know? Being able to fight with a spear, that's one of the neatest things, too. Doll shields end all locked like this. Now, something about the Argive shield. All along this outer room where this grip is, there'd be a rope. And what's very likely, I would grab the rope of his on his left side. And that would give a very, very, very sturdy grip. Which means if I move back, we don't have an opening. Generally, with the round shields, if I move forward, hey, there's a kill punk. Or if he doesn't keep up for some reason or another, gets pushed back. But with the hoplites, they have the rope, so if I fell back, well, it wouldn't really expose him or me to death. Which I'd say is a good thing, to not die in a fight. It helps, because you can live after, get their women, get their gold, you know, all the good stuff. So, again, I can fight very easily, underarm, over this little gap, which just conveniently happens to be by my right arm, can stab you, stab your mate, stab the guy behind you with a bit of a reach. With this grip, no problems. And let's say I'm in front of him. Not really framed for this perfectly. He's not really in danger with this grip. Yeah, I'm not really able to conk him, even if he is a bit closer. Still rather difficult. Whereas, hit the camera. Bloopers happen. Stay. Stop being hit. If I'm like this, as you can see, very much a danger. Not necessarily if he was right behind me, though if I thrust, come back, I can tag him, but if he was a third guy, as you can see, it's right at eye level. Right? So, yeah, not really good for your friends. So, yeah, you want your spear underarm in group. And I can use it. Another little note while I've got him here. If I was behind him, I could have my spear over him. Ow! Hit my elbow on this steel thing. Alright, that smarts. I can almost stab you. Oh, I kinda. What? If I had an overarm, I really couldn't do much unless they were immediately in front of us. And if I was just a step back, I could. I keep getting mixed up in stuff. Damn this long spear. Here, there's not much I can do. Whereas, here, would you look at that? I'm still in front of him with this spear, which is about 6.5 feet. So, you can present more spears, you have more control over them. It's a lot easier. You watch the rest of this video, you know my points, I don't need to sum them up every time. So, that should do it for this one. Tell you.